Let's say I mix oil, water and gas in a bottle. If we have a bottle at home, we can try this actually.
When the fluid mixture settles, due to each fluid's density, the water will form the bottom layer, the oil will float above it, and the gas will be on top. In the oil industry, the goal is to produce oil and choke the gas and water. This is challenging when looking at the fluids from a density perspective, because you have to extract the middle section. However, if we look at the fluids from a viscosity perspective, then the order of the fluids change. The lower viscosity will be gas. In the middle, we will have the water, and the highest viscosity will normally be the oil. This simplifies the task greatly, extracting the fluid with the highest viscosity, the oil, and choking everything of a lower viscosity below. The AICD, Autonomous Inflow Control Device, is normally viscosity sensitive and was developed to improve on the performance of the density sensitive passive inflow control device. There are many different types of AICDs. Most of them are either classified as a moving part AICD or non-moving part AICD. Let's have a closer look at a moving part AICD, as these are the ones with the highest performance. Fluids enter the AICD here. This part of the device has the same function as a passive ICD nozzle. The difference is that the AICD has the ability to choke the inlet by its moving part. In this case, a levitating disc which moves autonomously, meaning that it's self-regulating and requires no surface contact or control. The movement of the disc is based solely on the laws of physics when fluids of different viscosities flow through the device. To understand the physics governing the AICD, let's have a look at an aerofoil, the cross-sectional shape of an airplane wing. The basic principles which generate the lift force needed for a plane to fly also generate the lift force of the AICD's movable disc. When a plane moves through the fluid of air, the air, or fluid, flowing closest to the aerofoil's top surface will flow at a higher velocity than the fluid flowing along the bottom surface. This is because the fluid above has to travel a longer distance than the fluid below in order to merge at the same point on the other end. Let's call this velocity 1 and velocity 2. Because velocity 1 is higher than velocity 2, we get a higher dynamic pressure drop above the wing. By this we mean that the pressure is lower above the aerofoil and higher below it. Based on Bernoulli's principle, this pressure difference is what generates the lift force enabling the plane to fly. The same laws of physics are at work in the AICD. As fluid enters through the nozzle, a flow stream is created. Fluid will flow at a higher velocity above the disc, V1, compared to the velocity below the disc, V2. Just as with the aerofoil wing, V1 creates a lower pressure above, and due to the higher pressure below, lift force is generated, making the disc levitate. Because the AICD is viscosity sensitive, let's have a look at what happens when the three different fluids of oil, water and gas enter the device. Viscosity is measured in the unit of centipoise, CP. In our example, we'll use a medium oil of 7 CP. Water is 1 CP and gas is 0.02 CP. This means that the water will flow 7 times faster than the oil, and the gas will flow much faster than the liquids of both oil and water. If oil is flowing through the AICD, the fluid viscosity is high, and therefore the flow stream velocity is low. This prevents the disc from levitating, allowing the oil to flow through the AICD into the well. But once water is flowing, due to the lower viscosity, the fluid velocity accelerates, creating a dynamic pressure drop above the disc, making it levitate and choking the inlet. Because the viscosity of gas is 0.02 cp, almost 100 times lower than the oil, we get an even higher velocity and dynamic pressure drop, making the disc levitate higher and choke even more. To summarize, the AICD is dependent on a velocity difference above and below the disc in order to choke the inlet. As such, there are three limitations to its performance. Number 1. V2 can be accelerated by high-velocity counter-turbulence flowing under the disc, compromising the velocity difference needed between V1 and V2. Number 2. The main flow is the sensing part of the device. This means that the disc can never fully close and therefore never fully choke the inflow. A high flow stream has to be maintained in order to generate the lift force on the disc. Number 3. In this video, our example used the medium oil of 7 CP. However, light oil falls in the range of 1.5 to 5 CP and therefore has a more similar viscosity to water. This means that in reservoirs with light oil, you will find water and oil flowing at more similar velocities, thereby generating similar lift forces and reducing the AICD's ability to choke the water. In order to improve on AICD limitations such as this, the AICV was developed, a viscosity and density sensitive valve.